what are the key differences between lockout and tagout according to OSHA's definition, and can one be used without the other? Let's find out. First, let's talk about lockout. According to the Occupational Safety and Health Administration, or OSHA, lockout means isolating an energy source and physically locking it to prevent machinery from being powered on. This prevents any unexpected startup or energy release that could cause harm while the machine is being serviced. Now, what does that look like in practice? For lockout, you'll use devices like padlocks, which secure switches or energy isolation points so they can't be turned back on. You also have valve covers, which close off pressurized systems like gas or water lines, and circuit breaker locks to stop electrical circuits from being reactivated. There are also lockout hasps, which let multiple workers attach their locks to the same point. Next up, we have tagout. OSHA defines tagout as attaching a warning tag to an energy isolation point. The tag communicates a simple but important message. This equipment is being serviced. Do not turn it on. The devices used here are pretty straightforward. Brightly colored warning tags, commonly red, with clear phrases like do not operate or danger. These tags are usually secured with zip ties or similar fasteners to make sure they stay in place. Now, unlike lockout, tagout doesn't physically stop the energy source from being reactivated. It's more of a visual warning, something that heavily relies on worker awareness and adherence to safety protocols. So, if you're going to ask which one is safer to use, lockout is the preferred and safer method because it physically prevents equipment from being turned back on. OSHA requires lockout to be used whenever it is possible. However, there are special cases where a tagout can replace lockout. 1. If lockout devices can't be applied, like when there's no physical way to attach a lock anywhere on the machine or to the energy isolation point. 2. If the equipment is lockable, but the employer can provide full protection to the workers. That said, it's important to understand what does not qualify as proper energy control. For example, I once had a coworker who, in the absence of a proper lockout device, decided to use a cable tie to lock out the equipment. His reasoning? He thought it was close enough to a lock. This is a dangerous and unacceptable practice. Cable ties are not secure, can be easily cut or removed, and provide no physical barrier to prevent the release of hazardous energy. OSHA makes it clear, a lockout device must be durable, identifiable, standardized, and capable of holding the energy isolation point in a safe, inoperable position. They must also have a 50 pounds minimum breaking strength. To wrap things up, lockout and tagout are essential procedures for controlling hazardous energy and keeping workers safe. Lockout uses physical devices to prevent energy release, while tagout relies on warning tags as a safety alert. Lockout is always the preferred method because it's more secure, but tagout can be used as a backup when lockout isn't possible, so long as additional safety measures are in place. That's it. Thank you for watching. If you found this information useful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more lockout tagout tips and insights.